Hello there, welcome to this video. I will explain you how to improve sound quality in FL Studio 11. Please report any mistake in narration, leaving us a comment. Very important in audio production is improving the output sound once a project is finished. You may have bad peaks, saturation or bass channels that are too much overlapped by others. So you will need to compress or limit any channel. We will see three windows to do this. The first one is the limiter. You must know that the master channel does have a limiter by default. We turn it off to see better what the limiter does. For example, let's have a sick channel that is a bit saturated. This happens when its intensity is too loud. Select the slot related to this channel and add the 3D limiter on the right. In this window you have a graph that helps you to see how the channel waveform is in output during time. The white line indicates the effective gain given. When it's playing, it means that all the gain set is performed. In fact, not always the gain is fully given to the channel, like a simple volume knob. When such line goes up, it means that a higher gain is given to the channel, so you hear such parts louder. If the line goes downer, such part is put less intense. You have two envelopes. The violet one is the input channel, so the channel you would have with the gain set, but without any limiting action. The output one, so the one you actually hear, is represented by the white graph. Now use the gain and the ceiling knobs. Watching the graph, set the ceiling to decide the very maximum intensity that the output channel can reach. And this is shown through a green line. The output graph will always stay under such line. The gain set is the maximum that can be put. The ceiling set can't be overcome. The violet line is the gain value that will be fully reached 100% just if the ceiling line lets it. In this case, since you have saturation from the start, just put a lower ceiling and then just set a good gain. Sound will be much better. The saturation knob in red can find the ceiling set. Let's see now the second section. This puts a finer envelope. With the attack knob, you can decide how much fast the limiter must be in increasing the white gain in the graph. An higher gain means increasing the gain at a waveform peak in a longer time. Thing that will put at the same level different peaks very close at each other. Release does the contrary. It sets the speed of the gain change, but outside the waveform peaks. So an higher release time uniforms the waveform background and makes stronger the peaks than the lower levels. Mind that, on the left, you can set which graphs you want to see live. Let's see now the compressor. This can be done through the fluidic compressor. The compression is similar to the limiter approach, but the first one compresses the signal, which means reducing the high peaks and eventually improve the rest of the sound, through the gain and a threshold level. Differently than the limiter, the compressor acts just if the threshold is overcome. Gain can be used to improve or reduce the intensity of the channel. However, it acts equally on the total waveform of the channel, both intense ones and low ones. So, if you put a too low gain, you may lose the parts of the channel waveform that aren't truly loud. Then set the threshold. If the waveform peaks overcome such limit, They will be limited for a quantity set by the ratio knob. Reduction is made if the ratio is more than 1. Notice that this reduction is made just on peaks over the threshold. The rest of the signal won't be touched, differently from what happened with the gain. Here you can set the attack and the release time as well, just like with the limiter. There is another window that collects together compressor and limiter. Add the Maximus window. It may seem complicated, but all the lines you see are all the same ones just explained. Mind that this is a demo, so it means that when the project is saved, you will lose all settings on the Maximus at the next opening. You may need to purchase it to use this tool in full. In this window, the green line is the output level, peak per peak, and the violet line is the input channel. You can set here the ceiling, I indicate it through a dark red strip, and find it through the threshold knob. Here you have two kinds of gains. The pre-knob means pre-gain, and it's the gain found in the limiter and compressor windows before. The post gain is a gain put, ignoring all the maximum levels and limits set. Attack and release are identical to the ones just seen. On the left you have the saturator graph. This is another tool to improve the sound quality. Saturator means giving different output intensities to different input intensities. The point position indicates on top the intensity to give to the input, if its waveform has the intensity that corresponds to the point's height, that can be read on the right. Try it out! The Maximus window goes even more in detail, since all we have seen so far can be applied not just on the whole channel, but in its separate frequency bands. On the right you can choose the extension of each band, red for the lowest ones, orange for the middle ones, and yellow for the highest ones. Then you can choose which band to treat, selecting from the list on the left. And so, for each band, you can set the saturator graph, a gain, a threshold, and so on. The red, orange, and yellow lines on the graph represent the envelope of each band, so you can actually personalize the channel itself truly into deep. Too many lines may disturb sight and control. You can show and hide here the lines you are interested in at the moment. Well, this is all. I hope you enjoyed this video. Check our full series of tutorials for FL Studio 11 to learn how to create beats or a dubstep track. Thanks for watching.